Jenny?
Samantha? Samantha!
Jen, let me.
What are you doing out there?
You please let me in.
What? What? What?
I didn't know how to tell her what I had seen, but it was the guy from the junkyard. Now he was in my house. The voices I heard and the people I saw as a child.
There's a man over there.
There's nobody there, honey.
They were all coming back. I asked my Aunt Karen if she could come over and talk to me.
You just keep getting prettier all the time.
She was my mom's older sister, and I think she was the person I was most comfortable talking to now that my mom was gone.
What's going on with you?
I don't know what's doing it, but I kind of feel like I'm going a little crazy.
So what makes you say that?
I don't know, I'm paranoid. Constantly thinking somebody's behind me. Maybe I just need some sleep, but every time I close my eyes, I hear these voices.
Your mom never told you? She never discussed this with you?
No? Why?
She never told you that she also heard voices? And your grandma also? And considered it a gift? You have the gift too. Your grandma called it the whispering. She claimed to hear voices of people who had passed on.
But the more my Aunt Karen told me, the more I remembered things that I didn't understand as a child.
I understand that she's just a child, but I will not tolerate lying. And you condone it.
Just give her a little bit of a chance. She's not making everything up.
Experiencing it all now as an adult, I have to admit, I didn't really see it as a gift. I just wanted it all to stop.
You don't have to engage.
Sometimes I don't always have a choice.
You hear something right now? You hear that bird?
Mm-hmm.
It's been chirping the whole time, and we're just listening to it now. Now that we're choosing to bring our attention to it.
What she was saying made sense. But she didn't tell me how I could control it. She just told me that I'd have to figure that out on my own.
Looks like we got 5 new heaps in. Same drill as yesterday, you know what to do. Make, model, and anything that you can salvage.
Okay.
Knock yourself out.
It looked like dried blood. I needed to get out of the junkyard and away from these spirits.
Dad?
What is it, Jenny?
Can we please go home?
What?
I gotta get out of here. There's blood in the trunk on a dress, and one of the cars back there, and...
Come on, Jenny, I thought you outgrew all that.
You think that's normal? You think that's...
There's blood all over the place. It's a junkyard. If you need to go home, go ahead. I got work to do.
Please come with me.
If you gotta go home, you gotta go home. I got a lot to do here.
Please come home in an hour?
I will. All right?
It's after 4 a.m. He's never home this late.
Okay, well, if you're so worried, just walk back to the junkyard and check on him.
Seriously, where is he? Maybe something's wrong.
You're freaking me out. I'm going to bed.
Dad?
That old feeling started to come over me as I got near the stairs. There was someone else in that house with us. I tried to block it out enough to get some sleep, but they wouldn't leave me alone.
Hey, help me. Why did you do this? Please, where the hell am I? Get out of here, please. I know you hear me.
You don't know what she did?
Why am I here?
Why aren't you listening? Who are you?
You're not listening.
The best thing that you can do, control it.
Go away!
That night was the first time that I was ever able to take control. And once I did, I realized that choosing who I listened to was actually possible.
Bye.
You be good.
And I could also choose what to do with what they said. Who to help.
Take care of Dad.
I will.
Now, I really do see it as a gift.
Leaving?
Yeah. I'm gonna miss you.
I'll miss you too.
Mom says she's sorry for making you sell the boat.